Hello, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com. Today, speaking with you about the idea of the quantum Zeno effect and how it can improve the quality of your daily life. So this idea of the quantum Zeno effect is something that was originally thought about by Alan Turing. And he's the gentleman that brought us the Turing machine, which is one of the forerunners to today's modern computers. His original idea was taken a lot farther by researchers Misra and Sudarshan in 1977, who hypothesized that if you measure a quantum system often enough, you can freeze frame it in place. This was proven to be true in experiments that were conducted in 1989 and subsequently with diamonds in 2013, moving things closer to building those quantum computers. And then in 2014, the researchers at Cornell University, led by Patil, successfully demonstrated that these rapid repetitive measurements definitely can freeze a system in place. And they've quoted, there's a quote that was mentioning that they said, "The techniques demonstrated here," this is in their research paper, "augur intriguing prospects of realizing novel many bodies interactions such as measurement-induced dynamic coupling between the internal, motional, and topological states of a quantum many-particle system." So, if you're thinking this is kind of out there, what would this look like? Well, a fun way to think about it, and it actually was compared by some scientists to the TV show Doctor Who with these weeping angels. If you remember season 3 with David Tennant playing Doctor Who, and he was coming in on a TV screen to give some advice to friends of his to make sure that they didn't get caught up in the dangerous actions of these statues. At least they look like statues, but they're not statues. These are dangerous beings that can throw people back in time. And so Doctor Who is warning to his friends, don't blink, don't even blink, blink and you're dead. They are fast, faster than you can believe. Don't turn your back, don't look away, and don't blink. So in this kind of an emergency situation, you get that idea that you can use that quantum Zeno effect to lock something in place. You may not be facing weeping angels, but in my life, I actually did face an emergency. In 1991, when I was in Switzerland, I was living there for 9 months with my husband, my elder daughter. We're in a train station in Lausanne, Switzerland, walking. My husband was walking several steps ahead of me, carrying two heavy suitcases. He had his luggage, the baby's luggage, lots of stuff. And our daughter was just old enough that she could sit on his shoulders, grabbing onto his hair. And that was working pretty well until it didn't. When she let go of his hair, I was walking behind them, also carrying suitcases because I've got my stuff and some of the baby stuff. Babies have a lot of stuff. Anyway. I was horrified to see that she had let go of his hair and she's starting to arch her back and fall forward, backward off of his shoulders. And so thank goodness, all this time I've wondered, why did it seem to me like time slowed down to a stop? What the heck could possibly explain that? How could that even happen? And I know the official story is quantum effects only happen on the quantum scale. You know me. I've been tracking all sorts of what I would call macroscopic quantum phenomena happening in daily life since the late 1990s. So in this experience, what happened next is I heard sounds change. So the high-pitched click, click, click of women's high heels on that marble floor or granite floor, whatever it was, started slowing down. So the frequencies dropped. I could hear it in my ears. I could see that everything was slowing down. What am I doing? I'm paying attention just like Doctor Who gave advice. Don't blink. I was not blinking. Believe me, I was not blinking. I'm just staring at my daughter, somehow wishing that I could be right with her, cover all of that distance between the two of us. Somehow I did. And it didn't seem like I had to move like a ray of light, although maybe it looked that way to observers, because what I heard was a slowing down. What I saw was I could drop my suitcases, cover all that distance, and be at her side in time to catch her safely, which I did. Now, there are researchers like myself that would love to know how this ties in with human cognition. In fact, right from the start, that researcher I mentioned earlier, Sudarshan, the originator of the idea back in 1977, he had a quote which he said, And this is his idea. Sensations, feelings, and insights are not neatly categorized into chains of thoughts, nor is there a step-by-step development of a logical, legal argument to conclusion. Instead, patterns appear, interweave, coexist, and sequencing is made inoperative. Conclusion, premises, feelings, and insights coexist in a manner defying temporal order. This was quoted in a paper by Ottmansbacher, and some of the work being done in Ohio University by a wonderful researcher, Zhang Wang, and her colleagues are doing remarkable work showing that there is a link between all kinds of human cognitive systems and quantum processes, such as the quantum Zeno effect. And Ottmansbacher has a model for that. And so what these cognitive scientists are showing is that the way that we think of words it's got a very quantum framework to it, much more than a classical. The way we remember things, same thing. Pretty much any time you're thinking of things, making probability judgments, whenever people are asked questions and the sequence of those questions is changed, in all of these areas, quantum models are much more accurate. So getting to the point of today's video, what can you do about all this? Well, what you can do, and what's quite fun, is you can take a page out of the book Quantum Jumps. This is a book of extraordinary science of happiness and prosperity. Turn to page 190. Take a look at this picture. You can see a person ignoring the garbage in her life and focusing on the flowers and the good things. You can actually do that. You've heard of prosperity journals, of course, but you can make that a little bit better by looking at what happened, what went well in the last 24 hours that you personally had something to do with. Taking that little spin on the gratitude journal has been proven effective in helping people recover from depression. And what you're doing is you're focusing that quantum Zeno effect to speed up bringing good things into your life, just like you're able to slow down the bad things by staring at them and turning them into a good thing. Which brings me to my final favorite question that I love to ask in these videos, and that is to think about in your life, how good can it get when you think about using the quantum Zeno effect in your daily life? Till next time, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com. Thanks.